The results of the polls in four states announced on Sunday provide intimations of at least four tectonic shifts in our polity. One from cynicism about the electoral process prevalent, especially though not exclusively, among the urban middle classes and youth to a renewed faith in it. Two from identity politics to one that addresses the concerns and aspirations of the larger community of citizens. Three from populism to performance as the litmus test for parties. And four from the high command approach to run parties to one that is more federal and participative in character. The high voter turnout in all the states with youth and especially women in the forefront is a clear indication that hope in elections as a harbinger of change has prevailed over despair generated by the use of money and muscle power to win them. That hope cuts across all classes, castes and religious communities. Such a massive exercise of the franchise nails the widespread assumption that voters fed up to their gills with a skewed political system would stay away from polling booths. Noteworthy in this regard is the abysmally low percentage of those who opted for Nota EVMs. The highest was 3% in Chhattisgarh and the lowest was 63% in Delhi. Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh registered 1% and 19% respectively. The electorate seems to have regard Nota as a wasted vote, one that would not allow them to make difference. Seldom has the dance of democracy been more enthralling. Voter preference also indicate trends that deviate from those prevalent in the past. The impressive victory of the BJP and the even more humongous one of the fledgling Aadmi would not have been possible without support from all sections of the electorate. That includes Muslims, OBC and Dalits, traditional vote banks of the Congress and other parties like SP and BSP that swear by secularism and social justice. Identity politics rooted in the sense of victimhood of these communities appears to have lost much of its potential to garner votes. It might still retain some potential in states with large minorities and in those where caste is more deeply entrenched. Broadly speaking, however, the electorate today has other fish to fry. It seeks empowerment through education and acquisition of skills and not through tokenism. The UPA government's populist measures, ones that it projected as entitlements, haven't yielded a rich harvest of votes either. All parties in the fray did resort to them. But BJP did this in a calibrated manner to ensure that only deserving sections of the population were the beneficiaries, while the Congress spread the net much wider, especially in Rajasthan. Moreover, BJP in both Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh paid heed to last lime implementation of welfare schemes, something the Congress failed to do in states it governed.